众所皆知，正确处理电子废料的方式是将电子废料交给正规的回收商，然后他们会交给合法的电子废料处理厂。那么合法的电子废料处理厂是怎么运作的呢？又怎么做到无害环境管理？现在就带你来一探究竟国内知名的电子废料处理厂。
Any new product introduction, you will generate new waste. In return, we have to analyze this new waste which end of the day becomes the end of life, and then we have to find a home for it. So our R&D plays a very, very important role here, so that we are able to design a right methodology to extract optimally the targeted material. After we find out the right methodology, we do prototype runs to make sure that the methods that we develop can repeatedly get the same results before we go on a mass pro. Our vision is to manage this hazardous waste, okay? Especially those with intellectual property rights protection. So for example, like ICs, integrated circuits, printed circuit boards, because there are, you know, there's a lot of patent on it. When they come to my premise, we can put them into our sauna furnace and we can actually melt them into ingots. And then from these copper anodes, we actually go through the copper refining and we actually produce the copper cathodes. And as the anode dissolved in the solutions, at the bottom of the tank, you will find that you get the slime. The slime is actually precious metal. We go through our precious metal refining equipment, and that's when we get precious metal like silver, gold, palladium, platinum, which is 99.9%. Mm. And the copper cathodes that we produce is 99%.
还能使用的电脑硬盘经过消磁删除数据后将可以被重新使用，而已经损坏的硬盘将会被拆解并从中提炼金属如铂、镍和铝，铝需要在超过摄氏600度的高温下进行提炼。
These are not like pure aluminum ingots. We are making specs ingot. It has specifications. How much of aluminum, how much of magnesium insideHow much of silicon must be inside? They must fit into a certain specification. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it cannot be used as a raw material for my other customers.
不管是活法或湿法的冶金方式都会产生废气或污水。正规的电子废料处理厂就会有完善的控制污染系统，确保环境不受破坏。
If you go by pyrometallurgy, you definitely have particles. And particles before it's been discharged into the environment,you would have the air pollution control system, right, the back filters, to properly manage it before it's been discharged, meeting DOE standards. In our process, we use chemicals, then there will be fumes that will be discharged, okay, and the fumes has to be treated using a wet scrubber. We adopt continuous improvement to upgrade our facilities, upgrade our technology, to make sure that the technology that we adopt are green,And along the way, we have optimal recovery, meaning if there are 100 grams of gold there, I make sure that I try to recover 100 grams and not 50 grams. Mm. 50 grams, you're not going to be competitive. Mm. We can talk so much about the environment, but end of the day, it's still dollars and cents. So how do we help our customers to stay competitive? Mm. And this is very, very important. And then there's another factor we are talking about.Like purity. If the purity that you recover is like 90%, it's not good because you're not able to sell it at a premium price. So we have to make sure that we are able to compete globally.So that we are able to share the returns with our customers.
身为电子废料处理厂的业者，他们是如何看待大马人民的环保意识呢
？People awareness is moving on. Government is working along the line. And yeah, yes, we do collect more. That's awareness. But I'm sure.And definitely, there's a lot of improvement need to be done. Industrial waste is not a problem in collection. It's all in one place. Commercial waste, yes, there's a big challenge because it has to come from the consumer. Consumers' awareness is important. They have to know their responsibility. Make recycling or e-waste recycling as a way of life. Each and everything that you throw, you have to ensure that you're doing it properly.
很多国人没有处理电子废料的最大原因是不知道要丢去哪里。其实我国有178间向环境局注册的回收商，他们提供了各式各样的服务，帮助人民正确处理不要的电子产品。
So if you have three devices, from our list. Anywhere in Klang Valley, we will give you free pickup. So we will send you one of our drivers to collect these items from you and also compensate some cash reward for the items.
现在你知道将电子废料交给正规的回收商和处理厂是多么重要了吗？只要妥善处理电子废料，垃圾真的可以变黄金。